welcome to my channel. My name's Ashley Danielle, or my IGTV. I'm probably going to put this on both because I haven't been on YouTube or Instagram for a while for my videos. So I'm back with the new year, just 2019, after kind of like our New York trip and getting engaged and all of that. Videos will come for all the processes of like me planning and stuff like that. So get ready for those videos. But I just wanted to come back on here and say happy 2020. I cannot believe I've lived in a decade. Can you imagine? So yeah, next decade to come. We're in 2020. I can't believe it, but I'm so excited for what's to come, what God has planned, and what I don't know yet that I think I know already, but I have no idea. So I'm ready for 2020 and the years to come. So I'm super excited. And hit me up below or DM me what you're excited about for the new year. I'd love to hear what you're excited about and some goals and just the things to better ourselves for the new year. So let's get started. I just wanted to show you some cool things that maybe I got over January. We're still in January, but some new things I got that I'm excited about that maybe have been helping me in my new year, or also just fun. And just, I love makeup. I love skincare. I love journaling. So I have a few things to share with you. So let's get started. This could be, you say, my January haul, of little things. Maybe I'll do another one. I just wanted to put a quick video out there. You know, when you just, I didn't have this planned. It's like almost 12 a.m. my voice is raspy. Me and Nate went on a date night, so I had makeup on. So I was like, oh, let's use the makeup. So let's get this started. Just a quick haul for you guys. Let's get it going. All right. So guys, I wanted to share with you, a little story at least. I went to, San Jose to see my family. And, when we were there, me and Nate, when we were there, I had a date day with my mom and it was fun. And, I love makeup and, you know, she's such a tomboy. So she was just like, hey, you want to do my makeup? I need some new makeup. Maybe you can show me some products. So I was like, sure, let's go to Sephora. So we went over there and I knew that, the Mario brushes were coming out and I was super, super excited, but I was like, oh no, I'm going to be in San Jose. And, long story short, I got the last palette in San Jose of the Mario, brushes. So I wanted to share with you. They're super cool. I haven't tried all of them. I did try two today when I was doing my makeup and I really like my face today. Here we go. So Makeup by Mario, Sephora. They partnered. If you don't know anything about this, Mario is Kim Kardashian's makeup artist and just a great makeup artist in general. And he teamed up with Sephora to make these brushes. This is not a sponsorship for them. I'm not sponsored to say this video at all. I just know kind of the history of it. and so yeah, this is his first creation, probably of many, but it's super excited because it's limited edition. So I wanted to show you, I did open it already. So the box is so nice. So it's like this and then it opens and like you have him here and his signature and everything. And a little bit, I'm so excited to share with you my limited edition brush sets in collaboration with Sephora. I worked tirelessly to perfect each brush in this collection and I can't wait for you to try them all. I hope you love this special collection as much as I do. And then there's some in Spanish. Let me take them out. So I'm just going to take them out of their box. Oh my goodness. Okay. So this one, I haven't used this one yet. But it's the powder brush. It's, if you can see it, it's really nice and it's super soft. And it's not like so flimsy. It's just the right amount of flimsy and it's so good. So super excited to use this. Haven't tried it, but I can already tell you it's going to be great. This I used already, as you can see, it's not as white as that one. This one is the foundation brush. And again, it's like pretty tough in the sense of it's not like so movable to where it's gonna lay hairs on your skin. This one is the cheek one. I also use this one. I'm used to using a little fuller like of a brush. Like usually, good thing I'm sitting right here. Usually I use something like this. This actually like, and it's not like that, like, you know, like look at this brush. Like it's very like flimsy. And then look at this brush. It's not as flimsy, but it still like worked. So I'm so excited to keep trying this. I don't use a small one like this. So cheers to trying new things. This is the contour one. Again, sometimes I use a bigger brush. I mean, I use so many different brushes for contour. This is just one example. I use this for contouring today. So I love this brush, but I haven't used this one, but I would assume it would be just as good. This one is like nice and tight. This one I think is gonna give me a real good line. And then, yeah. So let's do this one. This is a highlight, so this would go like right here. And then this one is like your, whatchamacallit, your concealer. So under the eye, the brow, anything else you wanna conceal. I love it, I'm excited to use it. I really like the products that I use. And then I haven't opened this yet. So you're gonna open this with me. Ooh, and again, this like the buckle matches these. So cute. He did it on purpose. I saw a video that he said he did it on purpose. and then it's kind of hard to stick it in here, to be honest. I wish there was that thing I could just like stick the brushes in when you're in a hurry. But I really like this. This is really pretty. So we're done with the palette. Don't worry. I'm done explaining my love for makeup brushes. Next thing I want to share with you that I got from Sephora. I needed a refill of my Born This Way. Does anyone love this foundation? I'm actually wearing it today. You can do like a really easy, you know, quick look with this. Or you can, you know, put a little bit more on to get more coverage. So it's really good, really buildable. I would say like I really love the finish and how it stays on my face and how it wears. I really do like how it wears. And then I'm super excited. Of all the lipsticks that I have not tried Huda Beauty lipstick. Who would have known? So what I'm wearing right now is, let me see. That's not the one I'm wearing. This one is the one I'm wearing. This is a present from one of my moms. Can you believe it? I'm like, thank you. So the one I'm wearing right now is called Trendsetter. I love it. I actually put this on my mom when I was doing her makeup in San Jose, and I was like, I like that on you. And then this one's definitely a neutral. It's called Girlfriend. This is what it looks like. But yeah, so Girlfriend and Trendsetter are both really good nudes for my skin tone, even lighter or darker. To be honest, lipstick looks different on everyone, so go try it yourself. But I think these are really good colors to have in your palette. So that's what I got. That's what I'm excited about for my face and everything. Also, my hubby, we had a little date night tonight, like I said, and we kind of are exploring each other's love languages. And so he got me a gift because one of my highest love languages is gift giving. It doesn't have to be like physical gifts. It could be like not physical gifts, but it could be like a note or, you know, it doesn't always have to be like bought, but he did buy me a gift and I'm so excited because I didn't ask him, you know, like, oh, I like this, hint, hint, like he just got it for me. He got me this and he went to my favorite place here called Pigment. It's in North Park. If you're in San Diego, go check it out. I love Pigment. But it's this herbivore that I love. And then when you slide it open, it has this. Looks like kind of like a book. And then you open it. Oh! Then you got this. Super excited. Super cute packaging. Next thing is the AP Action Planner. I'm so sorry. I can't tell you where I got this because I found it. But there is something on here that says 90xmindset.com. And then it's basically something that you do for 3 months at a time. So either if you want to do this for a whole year and just do 3 month increments and like your biggest goals, your three biggest goals for 3 months. So me and Nate are actually doing this together. So we're kind of having like individual goals plus like together goals. So it gives you like what to do and like how to do it, like examples of your goals. And then it makes you do it, obviously. So then you go, let's get started, 90 days, so 3 months. So you do a pie of wealth, what your income is, you write all this down. It's good to write things down. And then you do like a pie, and then like, what else can I do to make more money? What else can I do to bring in extra income? And then it talks about a vision, like your vision board, what you guys have been, you know, thinking about that you want to start in 2020. Again, it's good to like really just like, it helped me, like me and Nate already had written these things down. But it helped us like, you know, talk about it again and write things down like on paper. So that was good. And then it talks to, it's like, now from all of those, circle your top three goals. And so we did, our top three goals, and then why these goals? Why do we have these goals? Why do we want these goals? You know, why? and it makes you explain it. And so we had to talk about it and explain it. And then it has like main action items. How are you going to accomplish, you know, 1, 2, and 3? So it has like 1, 2, and 3. Like, how are you going to accomplish them? And then it has like, we haven't filled this out yet, but like ideas. Like, what are your ideas? Just kind of like notes, jotting notes down together. And then it has like week 1. And you're able to put like the month. And you can write like what you're doing that day. I don't really use this as a planner. I wouldn't use it, but I would put like things that I have to get done for what I said are my goals. And then it has like action items. So then you have to write down like day 1, like what did you do to get towards your goal day? And for the first goal, the second goal, and the third, what did you do that day? And then, this is really cool. The follow do, because what you do is you set things for yourself, for your goals that you're going to do that day. And you have write in this how many minutes you want to spend. So an hour, you know, 30 minutes, 25, you know, like I want to clean my room, you know, and then you put 30 minutes, and then I want to research blah, 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 45 minutes, you know, and then you put over here on the other side, like how long it actually took you. If it took you more time, if it took you less time, so you know in the next day what you need to plan for accordingly. Or I never got to the third one on my goals because for today, because I spent so much time on the first one. And so maybe I should spend the whole day 2 just doing, finishing up what I need to do, because I can't complete all three of them. So just learning as you go, kind of like goals, you know, like me and Nate always say, like, we always plan like, okay, financial goal, career goal, this goal, and like map it out together. But sometimes like you have all these goals that you want to accomplish, right? Which is great to have. But sometimes like, what happens is life happens. God laughs at your plans. and sometimes the goals that you thought were going to be your goals maybe are turn around to be your goals later on. But sometimes they're totally gone and new goals come in, or things that you didn't think you wanted come in. And so it's okay to restructure your goals. And so that's why I like this, because it's like, okay, I had goals for the day. Okay, didn't accomplish them. So what do I need to do differently today too? And then you just keep going. And then I think you just keep going. And then when you get to week 2, then you do it again, like jot down what you need to do that week, kind of last week's wins and lessons learned, thoughts for the next week. Use this page to create an overview for next week. What big and small items do you have to look forward to? What are you dreading? Jot it down. So things like that can go in here. And then there's just a bunch of, like, you can write notes in the back too, just like blank pieces of paper. And then, yeah, it goes for 3 months. So there's things in here that me and Nate, like, for instance, like planning our wedding, and we want to buy a home in 2020, and we want to, pay down a lot of our debt in 2020. So yeah, that is some of our goals that I'll share, and, build our marriage, because we're newlyweds and we want to build our marriage and keep building. So, those are our goals, and those are something that we're, loving in 2020, and things that we can do for each other, things that we are doing together, and then individual goals too. So, I like this. If you liked it, go back, rewind, and see how you can get it. I think it's really going to help us. And I've been liking doing it with my partner. So Okay, Simply Inked is the company. We're gonna look at the tattoos. These are tattoos that I'm excited about because I wanna get more tattoos. I have one that says Fearless on my arm. But I haven't gotten any more. One, because they're expensive. This is called Simply Naked. this is what you get inside the package. There's tattoos on them, okay? But sometimes I'm like, oh, okay, it's permanent. Am I gonna want it for the rest of my life? So I wanna make sure. And sometimes like I won't get all these tattoos, but maybe the placement of where I want them to see if I like them on my arms. Cause I say I want my tattoos mostly on my arms and like, you know, the back of my neck and, you know, maybe under my bra line and stuff, but who knows, maybe I don't like it in that placement. So this is so weird. It's so cool to see it. I can read it. I can't read it when like this because it's backwards, but this one says She Is Art. This one came with the order. This one says Love. Oh my god, it's so weird to see. I can't, like, it looks so weird looking at it because it's backwards. So this one says Love. This is a little big for me, but maybe I'll put it somewhere, maybe on my leg, which I don't think I ever want leg tattoos. This is like, this again, it was free, like an arrow and like a heart wings things. I don't think I'd get that, but it's cute and I'll put it somewhere. This one, what does this one say? Serendipity. Okay. I did not get that from reading that backwards. Now I can read it. That says Serendipity. Yeah. So again, I think this is a free one. I don't remember ordering this. Okay. And did I order this too? I think this is another free one too. This one's cool. This one's pretty. What's this one? With Every Heartbeat. This is the one I ordered. So I'm excited. I like the font. I don't know if I'd get the wordage, but I do like how it's like a messy cursive, so like a signature kind of. So, and there's two of them, so that's perfect. I thought I was only going to get one of them. This one I really like. I ordered this one. I just like flower tattoos, to be honest. I think they're really pretty. I want to get a rose to symbolize growth. This was the only like rose I liked, and it's in a triangle. I don't really know the meaning of it. I'm going to look it up. I'm sure there's plenty of meanings. But I've seen some people have this on their arm before. It's just really pretty. A bunch of crosses. I thought I was going to get one cross because I really want to put a cross here forever. But I haven't yet. But yeah, these are a bunch of crosses. So I can try them a bunch of times to see if that's a tattoo I want to get. Then we have this one. This one's really pretty. No rain, no flowers. And I want to get something simple like this, on maybe my spine or the back of my neck. So that's good to look at. And then just another rose. So yeah, so I'm going to try them out. I'll let you know how I like them. But I'm super excited. They're supposed to last I think a week to two, depending on like how many times you take a shower and how many times you like scrub that surface, but they're supposed to last longer than like your average, like 25 cent, you know, gumball machine tattoo. So let's see how long they last. I'll keep you updated, but this was a longer video than I thought. I wanted to share a lot of stuff and I think I just wanted to talk to you guys. So like, subscribe, share, comment, DM me, whatever. I'm here. I'm excited for the new year and, welcome back for me. And, thanks for watching and I will see you soon. I promise I won't go far. And I will see you, hopefully very soon for my next video.